Hi, I'm Dumitru Popescu, the CEO of Arca Space Corporation, an aerospace company located in Las Cruces, New Mexico. The company started in Europe in 99, and since then we developed a series of aerospace vehicles, including world's largest solar balloons, composite material reusable rocket engines, and we designed, built, and launched rockets ranging from hundreds of kilograms up to 20 tons. We were also participating in the ExoMars program that was sending the ExoMars spacecraft to Mars by the European and Russian space agencies. After we moved the company in the United States in 2014, we continued with the development of the AirStrato high altitude long endurance drone. We developed the ArcaBoard hoverboard that is able to hover any over any terrain. And we continued the development of the HASS2CA single stage to orbit rocket. For the ArcaBoard technology, my company was awarded by the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, or DARPA, and the US Army with a contract to develop the ArcaBoard technology for military applications. And NASA, Kennedy, Ames, Johnson, Stennis, Marshall, Space Centers partnered with us for the HASS2CA rocket. Unfortunately, on October 24th, 2017, I was arrested while I was landing in Atlanta, coming back from a trip from Europe. The reason for my arrest was apparently a warrant issued by the New Mexico Securities Division with charges of securities or stock fraud. I eventually learned that the arrest was performed without an actual warrant issued in my name. Unfortunately, I was going to find out that I was lied to about the existence of this warrant, and based on this information, I waived my extradition from Georgia to New Mexico, but at the moment of my arrest, this warrant didn't exist. While I was in jail, my colleagues were informing me that I was charged as a fugitive from justice, which is something extremely weird, since the New Mexico Securities Division filed the securities fraud charges against me at 9:18 local time, and at that very moment I was boarding an Air France flight from Paris coming to Atlanta. The arrest was performed with around 2 weeks before we were going to perform aerospike rocket technology engine test at Spaceport America, and this engine is an advanced rocket engine technology. Slowly I started to see what is happening, and I had access to the evidence that was brought against me, and I was able to find what or who was behind my arrest. And honestly, at that point, I was terrified, understanding that the New Mexico Securities Division doesn't have in place mechanisms to prevent severe violations of law and human rights, as we are going to see further. What most people don't know is that I was briefly married in the United States for 6 months between 2016 to 2017, and a lot of people were speculating at the time while I was arrested, and now I'm able to tell you that this whole case started because of allegations of my former wife. At the beginning of March 2017, my ex-wife left our house, and at 2 weeks after that I was filing for divorce, and immediately after I filed for divorce she went to the New Mexico Securities Division and lied to the New Mexico Securities Division agent, and after that, a little bit later, to another agent to the Department of Homeland Security. The investigators apparently believed her, and they didn't question themselves if she might have ulterior motives, taking into account that she was my estranged wife. I want to be very clear that this case didn't start from complaints of investors, but from allegations of my former wife and Mr. Michael Persico from Anova Technologies from Chicago, who is a business partner of Arca Space Corporation and also has interest in my company, and whose name was given to the agents by my ex-wife. Based on the same allegations, the FBI was looking into my case, and they came to talk to me, and they dismissed the case. In spite of this, the New Mexico Securities Division agent decided to continue with what it can be best described as a witch hunt that included even silly things like him visiting Arca Space Corporation disguised as a disabled investor. Both Mr. Persico and my ex-wife, they were telling similar, pretty similar stories to the investigators, that I escaped from Romania and that I was planning to run away from the United States with the investors and the US government money. Mr. Persico was also abundantly lying to the state investigators on multiple accounts. Based on a poor understanding of ARCA's products and capabilities and business relations of my former wife, the state believed her untrue statements, and they chose to believe her in spite of ARCA's engineers and technicians were providing them with accurate information. And based on that, they literally created false charges. They performed, they might have performed a false arrest. They exhibited racial and xenophobic biases. They performed intimidation on me, my colleagues, and my family. And the agents went even as far as doing a potential collusion with Mr. Persico against me by together discussing a plan of my arrest and deportation in spite of having no charges against me. And they also invited Mr. Persico to put a charge on me, to choose what charge to put on me. And after I was released from jail, one of the agents advised me to sell my company to Michael. Even at 5 months after my arrest, they keep me secluded in Las Cruces, New Mexico, and in spite of the defense providing thousands of hours worth of hard evidence of video and photos, evidence, they my case is moving at snail's pace. And initially, the prosecutor verbally informed my attorney that if I make $1 million worth of restitution, the case might be settled. But after the defense presented exculpatory evidence, immediately after that, the prosecutor sent to my lawyer a written proposal for a deal in which if I plead guilty and I pay restitution of $74,000, the case will be over. But I refused the deal because I consider I'm completely innocent in this case. The agent from DHS keeps me secluded from my family and from earning any income in the United States, from interacting with my company, and I decided that this situation could not continue without me speaking out. I want to be very clear that this unveiling of facts is to show that the agent from the New Mexico Securities Division and the agent from the DHS were performing actions that, in my opinion, are violations of law and human rights. In addition, the same person that is director of New Mexico Securities Division and approved his agent to press a number of false charges against me is also prosecutor in my case. I consider it is my duty and my right to disclose to the authorities, to the public and to the press what the two agents together with the two witnesses were doing in my case, and hopefully to prevent future aberrations like this to happen in future cases. So let's jump into this. Prepare yourself to hear hard evidence and audio evidence. And I'm hoping that the institutions that I was also alerting, like the FBI and the US Attorney, United Nations, to look into this and to see if what the New Mexico Securities Division and the DHS agents were performing constitutes law and human rights violations. Also, you, the public and the press, please draw your own conclusions based on the presented facts.